As the Global Health Summit would be happening on May 21st in Rome, sponsored by both the European Commission and the G20 countries, there are a few very important issues that we need to talk about. And we believe that already there are mobilizations happening in Italy, and we express solidarity to these mobilizations on behalf of People's Health Movement. The serious issues that we are faced with right now in the middle of a pandemic, coronavirus pandemic, is that the large number of countries still are following a status quo in the way they look at health, the way they look at welfare, and the way the economies have been functioning. I will be speaking only on health, issues of health, because this is a health summit. We see that in the past many years, both G20 mainly has been following a very neoliberal outlook towards the issues of health. We have been seeing that increasingly it was supporting privatization and liberalization of health. Though G20 has been saying that governments should be spending on health, it has been encouraging or indirectly proposing ways in which, though the financing is by the governments, the provision can take place through the insurance sector and large private hospitals and, certain kind of privatization that we have been seeing over the years. So there is that issue that the G20, which is represented by both rich and a few middle-income countries, G20 also represents what is going entirely wrong with the way we see these welfare. And in the name of austerity, the funding towards health has decreased in all these countries, and all that actually gets suggested in most of the health summits of G20, let it be in Argentina or Japan in the past, has been that it looks at health as any other subject and looks for profits out of it. We are seeing that in the forum or in the discussions that we see about the issues around vaccines, medicines, medical products like, treatments, medicines, PPE kits, and so on and so forth in this pandemic. We see that the focus is still of many countries is on the profits of the private sector and not for the health of the large sections of the population. This in particular, though there has been, I mean, we have seen the proposal by India and South Africa, supported by around 100 countries, demanding for removal of or non-implementation of intellectual property rights in the context of COVID-related medical products for a brief period. Luckily, recently, this proposal was supported, has got some much needed support from the US, but it has been limited only to vaccines and not to medicines, diagnostics, and PPEs, and so on. So, what, and in particular, there are many G20 countries which are still objecting to this sort of waiver of intellectual property rights, which are a large barrier, which are a big barrier for accessing vaccines, medical products, and so on. And in particular, the European Commission, we have been seeing, has been functioning in a very anti-people's, and it has been working against the interests of people around the world by blocking this waiver. So, like the demands, I mean, we have read the demands of the mobilizations ahead of this Global Health Summit. And one of it mainly is that the public sector needs to be strengthened to deal with the production of vaccines, and which is very much rightly so, because this pandemic also reflects on the failure of the market to rise to the occasion, where we see that the same kind of profit and looking at people for profits has been happening even in the middle of a pandemic. So in the end, we feel that the mobilizations are in Rome in the coming days are very important and support the three main demands, which are that public production of manufacturing of vaccines and other medical products needs to be seen, and the countries which have not been supporting the TRIPS waiver should be doing it immediately. The second one is that the outlook towards health should also change, because healthcare increasingly has been privatized, corporatized, and liberalized in the past few years. And finally, when we talk about the way the economies have been in the past few years, there needs to be the health summit needs to reflect on how the larger economic conditions have been reflecting or affecting the health of the people. Because we also support the demands for changes in the way the economy is placed. I think we have demands for redistribution and debt waiving of the debt on various countries and so on. This will help a lot in the much needed finances for fighting the pandemic, and not just the pandemic, but also in general for all the welfare needs of these countries.